All right, it's Bruno with MB, where it can't all be serious. And we're going to try to keep it serious, Jeff. But there's nothing funny about recruiting.
I don't know if I'd bet on it. I don't know if I'd bet on that.
But yeah, we're talking about the hidden cost of hiring, right? And I like to hit right away. Number one, what do you think? You're a pro.
Turnover. The cost of turnover in a hiring error is estimated at 1.5 times the annual compensation for professional and management job categories. So, you know, if you add that up, it's a very high amount. If you miss at all on a new hire, mm-hmm. and that turns over, that's a extremely high cost.
See, I believe in the Kramer hiring method. Remember Kramer on
Seinfeld?
On Seinfeld, when he started working at a place, he wasn't even hired.
He just showed up,
and then they said, you know, we got to get rid of him. Yeah. And they had to fire him. It's like, I don't even work here. How can I get fired?
He's like, what's my severance package?
Or, you know? Yeah. But yeah, the cost of turnover is crazy. You know, like the wrong hires and
impact on your team too, right? I mean, if you kind of broadly group your current lineup of people into your A players, your B players, and the C players, like if your A players are, you know, burning out covering for C players, eventually that's not going to end well, and mm-hmm. you're going to have a rebuild to do on that particular team, and the cost of that will be, you know, in time, energy, money, your internal talent acquisition team, your recruiting team internally, HR, time cycles, all the marketing of the job openings, whatever channels you're using these days, recruitment costs, severance costs, we were talking about that. Mm-hmm. If you're making moves, ads, changes, like all those things, when you add it up, and you take almost any company these days, and the line item on your expenses called, you know, salaries, compensation, is going to be top three of all expenses for the entire company.
Right.
So when you start, you know, having monkeying around with that line item, it's the cost can go through the roof.
Well, you know what's kind of interesting? Just proper introduction for this episode. Jeff Applin is the present CEO, right, of the David Applin Search Group. And unless people watching here have been gainfully employed at the same job for over 46 years, they probably have heard of you. And it's a very, popular and effective type search company across Canada. And think about it, like your brand is everything that you have. You have an incredibly good brand. The cost of ruining your brand with a mishire, especially in this business, how would you, how do you fight that really?
Yeah. Well, you know, we do our best to make sure our clients are always happy with the outcome. And, we've always been the kind of company that will go the extra mile, and including things that are off of an actual contract or written agreement to make mm-hmm. sure that the client is happy, right?
You know, for those out there, seriously, that, we can tell stories. I don't know if they believe in
these
stories.
They wouldn't believe half
but
of them, probably.
Yeah, the employment world is it's the most undescribable type of industry, because it's the only industry that after you make the sale, your product could walk out.
Right? Change their mind, do something silly. Exactly.
And so, you know, what's number two, you think, of cost of hiring, or cost of the hidden cost of hiring?
I think it's really that team dynamic, right? And is what I was referencing. If you throw a wrench into a high performing team, and there's trust that gets broken, trust is one of those things that's, you know, takes a long time to build up and can be damaged in a split second. And so, when it comes to hiring and turnover, if you look at the impact on broken trust on a team, it can take years to rebuild.
You know, the other thing too is you guys, knock on wood, and congratulations on all the success. You're across Canada, and you've done it organically, haven't you?
We've done both. We've done acquisitions.
Acquisitions, yeah.
Also grown organically.
I was going to say that, because that too is not, cost of hiring, but the MA side of the game when you're expanding your business. Walk us through that. I mean, you've done that. That's what I was alluding to. It's not just hiring the wrong person. You're merging or buying or being bought by other companies. Walk us through that.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you know, if you want to grow, it's a good way in services to grow partially by acquisition and partly by organic growth. And for sure, I mean, we continue to look for companies to acquire and to blend into our organization. And we, for us, you know, really have a playbook around that in terms of the business that they're in and then all the hard stuff. But really, that's one with acquisitions. It comes down to the people that are going to join your team and are going to, you know, you're going to work with them shoulder to shoulder. And, you know, how long is that going to go on? And again, trust and fit and alignment of that and what they bring to the table that they're really good at that maybe, you know, we're as an organization could get better at through their joining us, and lots of respect for that. So yeah, it's a matter of really trying to find the acquisition targets that have all the hard business stuff that you need, but also the more important stuff is actually the mm-hmm. people and the longer term outcome of that. Because it's very easy to buy a company and then have it, you know, kind of not work out very well or fall apart because of the mismatch of the integration.
Right. Well, again, for the folks out there, is like, you know, I am being as genuine as I can. I have the utmost respect for your firm and how you guys have grown. And I mean, having been part of that industry for so long, with merging and hiring people, it's not the type of industry you would maybe agree that you don't go to school for and then graduate and kind of go, I'm going to this firm, but this is still this is a firm, right? And you talk about center of excellence. Walk me through what the David Applin Group considers center of excellence.
Center of excellence. Yeah, so our business model is based on deep specialization, recruiting by job category and industry. And what the center of excellence is in our model, it's a team of talent acquisition people, recruiters, that focus exclusively in one specialization. Mm-hmm. So that might be, for example, IT job categories in the defense industry, or it might be IT job categories in financial services, or it might be human resource professionals. So that's the model of bringing more strength through a team to deliver on a client search or opening than just one person working on one thing and somebody else working on something else, which is not really as scalable or repeatable or sustainable in business as the model that center of excellence model.
You know, that is really impressive because that is, you know, you call it a new strategy, new world, new whatever, but you guys have been doing that for a long time.
Yeah, well, it's also more fun, right? Yeah. Because it's, you know, that's where you start seeing, you know, when you're in the office, like high fives around the team because they just, you know, they got somebody to an interview stage or they got somebody to an offer stage. And there's that, you know, camaraderie on it, and it's fun to be part of a winning team. Mm-hmm. And people like to join a winning team. So, you know, we're always looking for people to join our winning team as well. And that's that kind of teamwork and collaboration. And that's a key part of that center of excellence model. And that's different. That's come a long way. Like, I mean, 46 years in business. So we've gone through incredible change over the years. And there was times for sure when it was much more independent workers, kind of patchwork quilted together. And, you know, hopefully things worked out. And often they did, but that wasn't really a model that you could really get more traction with.
Mm-hmm. You know, it is the David Applin Group, right? And people may interpret, because they see Jeff Applin, David Applin, they kind of think, you know, you're second generation, which you are, because you had started, but you had an incredible career in between. And then you took it over. You want to share that?
Sure. I mean, I worked for the company actually twice. So I worked for the company in the 90s.
Are you going to talk about your MMA career too?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, sure.
Martial arts, UFC. No, we're going to skip that.
Yeah, we'll skip that. We'll gloss over that. Okay. I worked for the company in the 90s as an IT recruiter directly in client service on a desk, and I loved it. It was fantastic. And then I was in my 20s. And at that time, I just realized, you know, I need to go live my life. Like, I need to do something else. So it was a tough decision all the way around. But I left the company, moved to Calgary, went back to Haskins School of Business at the University of Calgary, got my MBA, and then actually I worked for Deloitte Consulting. Mm-hmm. And they have a strategy and operations group that I was part of. And then after several years, I realized I was wanting to make a career move and was interested in, you know, getting into business for myself. And talking to my dad about it, he said, well, look, you know, we need a manager in Calgary. Why don't you come on board? And that was really the time when we said, okay, well, what would this look like long term as a family? Put our family hat on and put the business hat on. And what does it look like in both scenarios? And so I ended up working with my father for 10 years and then ended up buying the company.
Wow. You know, like people who haven't worked in family businesses, they're missing a big thing, but they're also missing a big thing too. I mean, I'm assuming. And but your tenure with Deloitte, what did it actually teach you coming in?
Oh, I learned so much at Deloitte because in that model, you got exposure to so many different companies and organizations, right? From oil and gas companies to crown corporations to private growth businesses. And you got to see how they make decisions differently and their mm-hmm. cultures differently. And you'd actually be on site. Right.
Right.
So that was a huge accelerator for what I liked about different organizations and cultures and industries and all that stuff. And what I thought, you know, probably I wouldn't last long in, or it wasn't really going to be where I'm going to thrive. And so I learned a lot and just tons of really smart people, mm-hmm. Really dedicated people, fun people to work with. So yeah, I still look back with really fond memories of my time at Deloitte.
So we talked about the hidden costs of hiring and all that stuff that you learned with the Center of Excellence and where you built with the Center of Excellence and, you know, your time at Deloitte. And I mean, that has to really help you with reducing that cost of hiring. And how do people get in touch with you guys?
Online, www.aplin.com. So that's www.aplin.com, or you can give me a call directly at 403-261-9000.
And how many offices?
8 offices, Halifax through to Vancouver.
Right. And just really quickly, what I call them verticals, industries, mm-hmm. If people are watching and they're looking for a career change, or if you're a hiring manager and you're kind of saying, look, it costs me way too much money to hire,
yep.
let me engage with the firm.
Sure. I mean, our wheelhouse is really the professional job categories and management up to senior management. So in information technology, accounting and finance, human resources, engineering and technical, those job categories are bread and butter.
So depending on how this video goes, I might have to be calling you guys, but we'll take our chances. But again, thanks again, Jeff. We're going to be coming back. We're going to be talking about you know, the benefits of, you know, contract staff, right? That's something you know quite a bit about. So this was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun.
Thanks, thanks for having me, Bruno.
Yeah, we'll be back next time.
Okay, right? Thank you.
Hey, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Remember, if you want someone you know to be our next guest, simple. Click below in the description and we'll get in touch with them. Thank you for watching and please subscribe and you'll never, ever miss another episode.